Hi, I'm back. This is pretty much where we left off. Just one thing, I did find this Santa Claus tag. It actually came like that, and I just cut this part off. I rounded my corner. Oops, sorry. Get you in camera there. So I cut this part off, rounded my corners. Backed it with some of the extra pattern paper, punched a hole and added in some twine. And I thought that would just be cute right there. I'm pointing to the knife. So that's there. So now we can go to the back of page three. And on this page, I'm going to do Christmas trees on both sides. I'm not going to stick this tree down. It's a wooden tree. I'm going to try to paint it and that, and I'll do that online and if it, or on YouTube if it doesn't come out right. I do have some of these chipboard trees I'll use instead, but I'm going to try to paint my little wood tree so it looks cute. On this side, I have a raised button. And I left it. I put it on pretty tight, but you can still slip a picture under there. I did go through and ink all my edges. And I'm still using the burlap, frayed burlap. So I'm going to put that right there. Peel off my tape so backing so I don't forget. My glue down. Our page where we want it. Press it down real good. And see the pages now that we're getting all the pattern papers on are laying down a lot better. They're not, the magnets aren't grabbing as much. Now when you open this up over on this side, I'm going to move this just a tad bit, get it in camera frame. I am going to do this piece here. And then this piece here. And because of the dove, I found this in my stickers. And it has, it was off this stuff that was right here. So I got peace. And then I used one of the little stars off this dazzle sheet. And then I just used one of my, those gem things. I'm not sure where those are right at the moment. It must be up here somewhere. Yeah, I don't know where they are. But that's what I did. And then I just cut this out of the leftover pattern paper. And that's going to go kind of slide right in there. So we can go ahead and put this down. I'm just adding my glue. Find where I want it. Get it where I want it and press it down. And then we'll do the same with this one. press that down very hard. Now for our little thing here, I think I am going to go with just across the top. So, just right across that corner. And then I'm just going to put this where I think it should be. Making sure not to go over that crease line. So we still want our pages to fold up. So, and that will go right there. So that's that page or part. And then this folds out this way. And for this, we're going to do the red stars. We're going to have the red stars here. We got just a little piece here that goes there. And then I have this little girl carrying the Christmas tree. And I haven't decided if I'm covering that. I don't think it looks too bad. I haven't decided. But that can go off to the side. So we're going to do this piece first. So we're just going to add our glue. And like I said, I'm not doing measurements in case your paper envelopes are a different size, because you don't absolutely have to use my side of envelopes that I told you in the first video. But I will tell you, it was 4 inches by 5 1/4, because I cut it so many times I got it memorized now. Put it down. Make sure it's down good. You don't want it to be coming up. And I don't, there. I don't know what that little piece was from, but. And then we're going to do this little piece. And we're just going to put glue all over. And I want it below the fold line and above the envelope line. So, right, I would say that my paper is either A, not even, or I'm not, my envelope is not even. I'm not sure which. Right there, I guess. Make sure that's, let's see. Okay. I'm still not happy with the way that's laying. I'm going to try to just, that's probably, sorry if my face and head and everything else gets in the way here. But I want to just trim a little bit of that off. See, I should have double checked before I tried to put it down. Let's see how bad that looks. I might have to add something to that. Let's see. What can we add? You know what? Right here. Because that looks so horrible. I'm going to put the sticker down. So I'm going to ink the sticker up. See, I read somewhere once, or seen it posted or something, where for scrapbookers, mistakes are just a reason to add more embellishments. So that's kind of what we're going to do. So I'm going to start it right there. Push it down real good. And when I get to this side, now I'm just going to snip right to there. There. Make sure that it's down real good. There, that doesn't look too bad. I'm still not really ecstatic about it, but that's what we're getting. Okay, now before we, so that's what happens there. That doesn't look too bad, it will work. So peel our score tape back enough there. And then we're gonna glue this down. I'm going to go right there. Awesome. Good. So that's that. I got glue on my fingers. It's coming off of my papers. Now she can go right back in the little pocket. And that's page 3. What do I have here? I think I lost something. I did. There. Okay. Now onto this side. I am going to go ahead and stick my pattern paper down. So you can kind of see my stuff back there. But that's going to go right there. Peel off my backing to my score tape so I don't forget. Then we're just going to glue this piece down. And we're going to place this. Like I said, these two tags are going to go here. This one says under the tree, which matches that. And we're going to try to make this tree look real pretty later on. So, let's see. I think this unfolds. So, we're going to go this way first. Let's see, what do we have here? We just right now have plain photo mats and the red stars. So we're just going to glue those down. Oh, see. Remove our backing from this magnet so we don't forget it. Put down where we want it. Then we'll do this piece. This piece down. Just right. See, this glue sticks so well. You have very little wiggle room, so. Okay. And then when we flip it up this way, let me scoot this down a little. We are going to do. Stripes and stars. I thought they went well. Then we have red stars here and red stars on the back, and I already did ink around my edges, so we just gotta glue these down. And then this piece will go up here. So that one is now complete. Other than our sentinel tree, which we'll have to come back and do that. So then we can turn the page. Now these two are just kind of a little plain. I just didn't want to cover up this. Or that really, but I thought there's still room for journaling or a picture here and journaling here. Either way, and it surely doesn't not look like I inked these, so I'm going to go ahead and ink these pages. So I'm just going to go right around and ink up a little. And then this piece can go down. And then we're going to ink this page. On this one, and then we're on to this next page, and I think this is the last one. And what we're going to do, let me move all this stuff. is we're going to have this say happy holidays all the way across. And that's going to be our back cover. Now, I thought it doesn't go all the way. So I measured this to fit right there. And that will be a pocket. And we got this reindeer here that we're going to put in our pocket. So that's what this is going to be. And I didn't ink this one either. So we'll start by inking up our pages. I'm not real meticulous about inking. I just kind of toss it on there. This has some color there. Okay, and that's going to go there. And then this piece, move this up. So if you have a piece of paper you want down somewhere, but you think, oh, it doesn't fit, add another little piece to make it into a tuck spot. You could go tuck spot this way, tuck spot this way. But because mine was short this way, I'm going to add it here. And I just thought we could make these stripes kind of continue on. So that's why I picked this. And I want that brown stripe to start right where that brown stripe starts. So that will be like that. So let's peel off our score tape here. And we're going to put glue on this side. Get it centered on here as best we can. Push it down so it gets good contact. Then we'll do this page. Just going to put our glue down. Now we got our crease here for our just kind of line it off that crease. We don't want to block that. And then we have another crease here where this side comes up. So we want to make sure we don't block that. We want our paper to go right there. So let's make sure, yeah, that's fine right there. So we're going to do just three sides. This bottom, this top, then right down this line here. And then we're going to set it down right here, I believe. Make sure it's tucked around okay. Make sure that goes. And that's And then our card will pop right in there. Just like that. Okay, now this does pull out. So, on this side, I'm going to go with this paper here. And I have this tape here, and I did cut a little bit of it off. Otherwise, it would have been too long. And I'll back it on with something. It might be this or whatever. So, start by inking these pages up. And remove our tape right here. Add our glue. Going to remove our tape for now. See how this one's fine. So we're going to move this up. And then we're going to end this page. So that will go right there. Excuse me for a minute. Oh, excuse me. And we're just going to put glue on here. Press it down. Okay. Now, let me cover that up for a minute. I'm going to move this up a little out of our way. And I think I'm going to use the same as what I used on the other one. I think I'll use the words. So I'm just going to glue this right to the back here. So I'm just going to put blue on the back of this tag here. Make sure it's where I want it. Give it a good press down. Right here. Sorry, just bumped the camera. So hopefully I can get this where I want it. Sorry about all the wiggle. Oh, I hate when I bump it. Okay, good. Sorry about that, folks. Probably made y'all so sick. And then I just go right along the edges and cut it out. And this side too. Now I take my big crocodile with the larger of the holes. And I just try to center it. I'm not. And give it a punch. Get some of my twine. I just cut off a hunk. I probably waste more than I really need to, but I'm always afraid I'll make them too little. And I'd rather cut more than I think I need than less. Because you're still going to waste it if it's too little, so. And then, see, I might put some of that stuff down, just to glue it down so it stays where I want it. But that's our tag then, for there. Sorry, that's our tag over here, right there. And then we're going to flip this down. My camera really moved a lot. And for these two pages, I have the music sheet. And I'm just going to ink those up. And those will go there and there. So we're just going to those up. So that one will go there. paint this one up. So we're just gonna put our glue down. And then more glue on this one. And that's going to go right here. Just like that. And this paper has so much sparkly, you really don't need a whole lot of embellishments, because you got all the sparkly and it's got some texture to it. So that's where we are. And then we already did our see, if you remember, this is gonna close up like this, this, and then this is gonna come and sit under like that. So we did all this. We got that page and that. We got all our pages done now. We got our little one here done. And we're just gonna do this one now. And I have Christmas tree paper here. I just need to ink that, the edges on this. Add our glue. So we're going to put our Christmas trees down. And then I cut Santa out of the paper, and I am going to put him right here, and I'm just going to glue his feet down and here down. And then I have 'tis the season to be jolly, because he's a jolly old man. And I will cover this, because I don't like that color with this. But 'tis the season to be jolly, and he's going to be tucked behind Santa. The only thing is, Santa needs to be a little inked up on the sides. So I'm just going to go right around Santa here. Give him a little brush with the blending tool here. I'm just going to put glue at his, on his feet. And up on the top. I kind of want his, I don't want the parasites to end up bending. So, now, I just get him where I want him, and I stick him down. Give him a little pressure there, along with his feet. And there's Santa with the Christmas trees behind him. He's got a sack full of toys, and this will go right behind him. So let's cover that tag, and we'll be done with the inside of our book. So I think I am going to use this paper again. And I'm just going to go right next to my other tag that I had cut out. And I'll just glue that down. Just fall right along the edge. And a little bit right here. There. And that's how we're going to do it. And then we'll take our distress ink. And just go right around our last tag here. And I always do both sides, especially on this side, because with that brown, it will really add some character, dimension, or whatever you want to age to it, make it look vintage-y. So, then we'll just slide that right in there. So here we go. Now let me get everything a little in perspective here for us. We'll come back next time and make a bow. But when you open this, and it is like a box. Oops, that's the one part of it. You got a box. We're going to put a bow here so it will look like a present. You open it up. You got Christmas here. The Christmas day with 25 with the little calendar back there. You got a photo spot here. This is that back cover we just did. We have our Christmas checklist. We have our pocket with a tag. We have our Merry and Bright. We got two tags here. This flips up. We got tags in this pocket. A photo mat. And then it flips this way. More photo area. We got this side. And that flips down. We got another tag here. And then we got our two photo mats here. Next page is our nice and naughty page. So there's our nice with the Santa Claus tag and a photo mat. Naughty page with a photo mat. Turn the page. This is our Christmas tree page. And besides the bow, we're going to try to decorate our wood tree. This page lifts up. We got a pocket here. Photo mat, photo mat. Two photo mats here with a little tuck spot there. Then on this side we have, this pulls down, two photo mats there. We got photo mats there. This is hopefully where our tree is going to go. And then our next page is our ornament and Noel page that we kind of left blank. And then our last page that goes this way with the music notes and up like this. So we got that. And we got a tag here. We got our back cover that says Happy Holidays with our back cover. We got a pocket there with a reindeer. Our Christmas list, and that's it. Then all of that closes it right on up, like a Christmas box gift. So that's our album. Like I said, I'll come back and try to tie a bow and color our tree. And I'm thinking color and then maybe some, some kind of glossy paste or something to give it some texture and some more paint. And then maybe some red gems as bulbs. I don't really know. And see if I can tie a bow for the front. So thanks for joining me. I hope I inspired you to do some of your own creation. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment below. Like, subscribe, and pretty soon we'll be on to a new project. Thanks. Bye.